Hi guys, and welcome back to SITENG. Today's video is going to be the last covering the capping beam, and in today's video I want to show you the builder's work drawing. We're going to have a look at the penetration which might be coming through the capping beam shown on this drawing. We also going to have a quick look at the drainage drawing, but we obviously going to be interesting what might be coming through the wall through our capping beam, and we're going to be going through the perimeter of the beam, and at the end we're going to create our working drawing where we're going to put all information on the one drawing, which is going to make our life easy. We're going to do some markups, and we try to put, as I said, all the information on one drawing while we're going to be keeping all the drawings anyway, but that's going to make our life easy. So yeah, let's go. So guys, after we have our GA ready, we went through the sections, through the elevation. We also had a look at the rebar drawing. There's two drawings also we need to have a look when we're going to be doing the capping beam. And obviously in the later phases, we're going to have a look again at them, at closer look. But there might be the information, the interesting information on these ones as well. This is the builder's work drawing for the basement level. And this is a tender issue actually, so we're not going to be using this. We just want to make sure this drawing is going to be for construction while we're going to be doing the basement slab, as this is for the basement slab. But because we're doing the capping beam, we want to make sure we know about the old penetrations here as well. And this is the legend, but this is actually through the slab, and this is not going to be through the basement slab really, because you're not going to be installing the fire collars, the hilti collars in the basement slab probably, but we're going to have a look at it when we're going to be doing the basement slab. So what I want to show you here on this drawing, that we got a penetration here, and we want to make sure this penetration corresponds with our capping beam drawing. And in this case, actually, if you remember on the previous videos, we got the old penetrations below the soffit of the capping beam. But what we want to make sure on this one, we want to make sure that we have a correct number of penetrations. In this case, you can see the fireman, the spare one requested by client. So what that means is that actually the client could agree with this designer about this spare duct, but maybe the structural designer doesn't know about it, so he never even showing this penetration through the wall or through the capping beam. So this is the small bits and pieces we want to have a look, and we want to ask the question on time before we actually construct it. But as you can see here, we got that penetrations here, so we had a look at the wall elevations for them, and we know they're going to be here, and we're going to check them. And actually I want you to check this, if this is all correct, as I'm gonna allow you to download these files and all these drawings, so you can compare yourself. So this will be available on my website, or I'm still actually thinking about the LinkedIn website or the Patreon. So if you got any ideas, you maybe leave me the comment below where you think I should leave these things, and where you want to find it really, and where you want to communicate with me, because I'm gonna choose finally one platform where it's gonna be just easy to communicate with you guys. So that's the builder's work. So as I said, you're gonna have a look yourself, and I'm gonna also open the drainage drawing. So the drainage drawing here, we want to make sure, same story as before, if we got any penetration, if there's any drainage coming through our capping beam, and we want to make sure we got it in. There is a lot of information on this drawing, but obviously I'm going to go through this soon when I'm going to be covering the pile caps here, as we want to make sure we got all drainage installed while we're doing the pile caps. As you can see in this case, there's actually designer showing us there will be pipe going through the pile cap, through the concrete of the pile cap, and we need to install this before we pour it. But as this is the capping beam, we only interested now in the capping beam, and we're going to go through all the perimeter here to have a look if we got any pipes or any information that we can pick up, and we can double check with all the rest of the drawings. So yeah, as you can see here, we got something coming through the wall, so it might be actually through the beam as well. So that's the one, and we go in here. We got here the information, the invert level of the pipe, which is 44019, and the pipe diameter 150. So this is below soffit of the slab anyway, but just remember, this is the invert level, so top of the pipe going to be around 44200. So that's the level we need to clear. We need to make sure we're going to be clearing with our capping beam, let's say, yeah, 44200. So if our soffit is above it, we're going to be all right. And we want to go all around it we want to take, we want to double check if we need anything else, maybe if there is something maybe missing on the structure drawing. As I said, this might be different designers covering the drainage, different designers doing the structures, and the different designers showing also M&E, all that builder's work drawing. So that's our job, that's our engineer's job, to make sure we got all information combined, and that we're gonna pick up any discrepancies if there will be, and we're gonna make sure we're gonna do the proper job. We're gonna preempt these things if they happen. So same story here, we got pipe here coming through the wall, we're gonna double check here invert level 4405. Same story, this is invert level plus 150 pipe. That means they're gonna be 40 or 220, let's say, for us, gonna be the safe level to clear. So guys, this time I think in terms of drawings, we got all information now. We got GA drawings, elevations, sections, rebar drawing, and now we have a drainage drawing and the builder's work drawing. So we got all information about the capping beam and we are good to go. And before we're going to go do anything, I want to prepare and I want to show you what I'm doing on the jobs. I'm making a drawing for myself and I call it the working drawing, which makes my life much easier while I'm working on site, as I'm trying to take the most important information on the one drawing. And obviously, as I'm keeping reminding you, you need to get this drawing all printed and all the time with you so you can refer to them. But obviously this one drawing, the working drawing, gonna make your life easier. So I'm just gonna show you what I'm doing now, and I'm gonna go back to the GA drawing, and this time I'm gonna use block C for this. That was block A, showing the drainage and the builder's work, and I'm gonna make a working drawing for block C, and obviously I'm doing for all of them anyway, so I'm not gonna be wasting too much time to do the same thing for both blocks, obviously. But once you're gonna be building this, you want to make sure you got it ready. So what we can do, what I always do, this drawing is not that bad, but I still, once you're going to be constructing the beam, you obviously you're not going to be working everywhere here. So let's say we're going to be working from grid line C3 to grid line C9, this direction. So what we're going to need now, we're going to need only this bit of the beam, and we can print the drawing for ourselves. We can print the 8-3 drawing, and we're going to get there all information. So let's see, control print. I'm going to get the window here, and that's going to be my window. I'm going to get it to grid line XXB, or even maybe I'm going to go past CL to this section here. So that's what I want here. Okay, I'm going to print it now, and I'm going to call it maybe the working drawing. Working drawing, and I'm going to put it as this is revision C6. I'm going to put it C6 for myself, so I'm going to know which revision it is actually, and still keeping the older drawing with myself anyway. So I got it here. Actually, I saved it as a PDF, and when I'm going to print it, it's going to be obviously the bigger sometimes there is too much information on one drawing, so you want to divide it into sections so it's going to be easier for you. And what I'm going to be doing here, I'm going to actually put the information for myself here as well. So I'm going to do some markups here. For instance, what we got here, we got a section, as you can see here, we got the section 3 from drawing 35, we got section here 6 from drawing 35, section 16, and actually there's still section 16 here, and section 12 here. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm maybe use the different colors here to show you how to just mark it easy for yourself. So I'm gonna mark this one yellow, I'm gonna mark this section maybe green, so this is coming to this wall here. So that's our another section, and I'm gonna maybe mark this section as well here. We're gonna go maybe just up to here with this drawing, so I'm gonna change this, maybe I'm gonna do the color like that. And section 12, this section, probably I'm gonna make another drawing for myself, and I'm gonna keep this section there, so I'm not gonna be using this drawing for this part. So let's say I'm gonna do it from grid line C3 to grid line C9, covering this section here with a blue color. And What I can do now, I can actually go jump to this section, and this is section 3 from drawing 35. I got the drawing 35 open here, and I'm just going to cut this section, section number 3, and I'm going to copy this for myself. I'm going to put it here. So that's going to be my section 3 from drawing 35. So that's what I said, guys. This is good for you. You see the beam here. You got a section here. I quickly do maybe another one here, which was number 6. I'm going to cut this number 6 here. I just copy this and paste it here. So I can print later for myself, maybe make it a little bit bigger. So now we got the information here on one drawing. We got the beam view, beam GA, and we got a section on the one drawing, which is very good. What I also doing always, I do like a small table, and this might be, I'm going to show you why we're going to be doing the pile caps. This is very useful, but I'm going to show you what we can do here. We can actually create a table here, or you can just print the drawing and just use the marker and put the information, which is important for you. So we're going to create a little table here, and you can actually just print a drawing and then do the table later with the marker for yourself. But the first level we're going to need here for this, that's going to be actually the deck level for ourselves. We're going to put the deck level, and the next one going to be the blinding level. We're going to do like that. Then we're going to have a cutoff level for ourselves. And what we can do, actually, we can do top of concrete level as well. So that's what I'm going to be doing. So you can see here, actually, you got this information here about the top of concrete, TOC, top of concrete 46 to 50. And this is correct on the section 46 to 50. You got 1 meter beam here and the 75 mil projection of the piles. This we can also check with a pile cutoff level as well. So what we have here is 46 to 50 minus 1 meter beam, that's going to be 45 to 50. And if we're going to go for 50 mil blinding, that means our dig level going to be 45 to 100. So I'm going to put it here, 45 to 100. Blinding level, so the blinding level is at the soffit of the beam, so obviously this is the level here, so that's going to be our 46 to 50 minus 1 meter beam, so that's going to be our 45 to 50. So this is the blinding level, and the cutoff level going to be, as you can see here, we got the 75 mil projection from the soffit of the beam. So that beam's going back to our table. The pile cutoff level going to be 45 3 to 5, and the top of concrete, so we actually have it here, but we can put it anyway for to make our table ready with all information. So 46 to 50. So that's what we got for this section. So we got all this table here. You see, we got that setting out the information on this drawing as well. We got the columns here, and now we got the section. We can have a look at this section. We did this table for ourselves. We can maybe make it more visible. And we're gonna move it here, so it's gonna be better for us. So obviously we're going to do the same story here for this one as well. So 45.875 minus 1 meter. I'm not going to be repeating this, as this is going to be exactly the same, just taking different levels and marking for yourself. So that would be, guys, my working drawing when I got all information on the 1A3 paper, and this is my first drawing. I know the sections, I know the dig level, blinding level, cutoff level, top of concrete. I got the coordinates here actually on this drawing. So this is my one working drawing, but as I said, you need all the drawing with you all the time anyway. To make your life easier, you can actually make a few more copies to leave it to foreman, to leave to the last on site, so they know actually what they're doing. As I said, the communication is the key on site, but that's the one working, and this makes your life easy. Trust me, once you stress, once you're under pressure, you want to have this information on the one drawing, and then later you can always refer to your original drawings. So I think, guys, that will be all for today. I hope you like this video, and if so, just leave the thumbs up, leave some comments, guys, and please subscribe to this channel, as there will be more and more coming. And I also want to allow you to download some stuff, to have a look at this, and want to create a community when we all can discuss things like this. And yeah, guys, so yeah, stay with me, and thank you for watching again, and see you next time.